So let me give you my introduction. I am Amit and I have a total year of experience, 5 years, and I'm currently working in Google as well as I am taking classes in various institutes for Java programming. And I take classes on both international and national level. So I take classes for US candidates in India and some other country candidate as well. So today, I'm just delivering this lectures on Java. I will be the instructor for this throughout the course. So let's start about it. Before start this object-oriented programming and Java programming language. So in this course, I will going to teach you about the full stack programming, full stack Java. So before going ahead, I just wanted to know from you guys what you know about Java and what make you to take a decision to start learning Java programming. So based on that, I can prepare you for the interview placements and as well as I can give you as much as project knowledge. So what do you know about Java programming? Anyone can try. What do you know about Java programming?
It is a powerful language, sir. We can write to so many applications. We can develop so many applications using Java.
Okay,
and
great.
Full stack development, it is very useful in creating web applications, sir.
Correct.
It has many tools like REST APIs and MongoDB and some of it has provided many libraries. So we can use that by using, we can use that for developing web applications. And also it is a major applicable in the field of Android applications also.
Okay, great. Yeah, thank you. Thanks. So as you said, it's correct. So with the help of Java programming language, you will going to develop application that is based on desktop application. You can develop mobile application. You can develop a network application. So a lot of application you can develop. Android that you said is again based on Java. However, its syntax are different, but it's again similar to the Java. So in this syllabus, I will going to explain you front end and back end as both. So in object oriented programming Java. So in this course, we're going to see what is OOP concept and what are the importance of Java, what make Java different from other language. And we're going to see about OOP concept, exception handling, and front-end part. I will going to cover all those. And this is about the syllabus part that already might be shared with you, but these are there's some basic that I will going to cover. Inheritance. Basic means in this particular slide, what I will going to cover that I've added here, basic, inheritance, data structure. This is about 2 to 3 days. We're going to see about the basic GUI, okay? So now let's come to why Java is important. Before Java, in your academic, you might have learned C language, C++, MATLAB, or any other programming language. But what make you or what make you to learn Java, or what make the whole world to switch to the Java? Do you know the reason behind it? Any one of you? The reason is platform independent. What do you mean by this platform independent? In C, C++ language, whatever application that you were developing, okay, in C, C++ language, whatever application that you were developing, they are not platform independent. What do you mean by this term, platform independence?
We can run Java code in any application, sir, because it is not platform dependent.
Yes,
it is not particularly dependent for a system or particularly dependent for a version of the system. If you can run Java,
correct. So you can, yes, correct. So you can run your Java application on any operating system, whether it is Windows, Linux, Mac. Have you done work on Linux operating system, Mac, apart from Windows?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Java application are those that can run on any operating system, whether it is Linux, whether it is Windows. And so I will going to tell you like how you can run application on different operating system, Linux, Windows, Mac. Of and another reason that why this Java was important, because it gives you both. You can develop front end and back end as well. Earlier days before Android, which operating system we are using in mobile? Is anyone know?
It was Symbian OS.
Yes, those operating system are built on what language? Java programming language. Java programming language was used to build those operating system because they were not to make it platform independent, to make those application run on any hardware, any operating system, any mobile. Because before Android, there was a common operating system that we were using in a keypad mobile. So that was the one reason. Another reason, portability and security. Portability means same thing. Suppose you both, Afzal and Supriya, you both develop an application in Windows operating system. But you have a one company, you develop an application and you want that application to be run by every user, irrespective of operating system. Suppose if I have a Windows, I should be able to run an application. If I have a Linux, I should be able. If I'm Mac, then I should be able to run. Then only you will get in a profit, right? Suppose if you make an application for only Windows, then other operating system or other user, those who are using Mac and Linux, will not be able to use it, right? So the term portability means you develop an application on one operating system and you can use it in any operating system, similar to the platform independent, but portability is more a standard term that can reflect this platform independent. And security, Java application are more secure as compared to C++ language software. So these are the two reasons why make Java popular among other programming language. Is it clear till now?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay. And you might be aware about this history that it's already developed by James Gosling in 1995. And after that, there are a lot of version was available. But do you know, when Java was developed, it was under Sun Microsystem. Do you know now Java is under which company? Or who owned this Java? Who owned the license of this Java operating system, Java software? Any one of you? Oracle. Now, Oracle is holding the license and copyrights for this Java and Oracle database. And after this, lot of version was developed. Current version of JDK, Java Development Kit, that is available now is Java SE 17, which recently developed in September 2021. Okay, so there lot of version of Java was developed and it is owned by Oracle now. So normally in many like cities or like in many institute, people, they will going to teach you, or trainer will going to teach you Java in three courses. They classify into three courses: J2SE, J2ME, and J2EE. J2SE means Java 2 Standard Edition. J2ME means Java 2 Micro Edition. And J2EE is Java 2 Enterprise Edition. What do you mean by this? Anyone having any idea on this? So Java 2 Standard Edition means what? It is used to develop an application that are web-based, that are client-side application, not web-based, client-side application, like your calculator, date, time, clock that you can see. So J2SE is used to develop a client-side standalone application desktop application, you can see it, right? J2ME was addition was added to develop a mobile application, so that people, they can develop a mobile application for their device. Okay, mobile application, we can develop it. So we can develop a mobile application, right? Earlier days before Android, all the mobile application, they were built on Java, and their operating system was also in the Java. Then J2EE is a server side application where we can develop a web pages, where we can develop website, server side application, where we need to connect to the server, like website, they connect to the server, right? Amazon, anything. So they connect to the server.
Yes, sir.
Right. So normally, like when we type anything here, okay, I'm just typing here Oracle Java, right? So I'm typing here Oracle Java, and I will going to press enter. This will going to, as you click on the link, it will going to connect you with the Oracle server, right? So the communication that has happened, the connection that has happened between the Oracle and the server, we do it with J2EE, Java 2, yes, Java 2 Enterprise Edition, where server is deployed somewhere else, and client is your browser or through which you are connecting. So through which you are connecting those. So that is called J2EE. So these are the three edition of Java. Earlier days, people, they were introduced the courses with a different edition. But in this course, I will going to explain you J2SE and J2EE. J2ME is not there because we will not going to develop any mobile application. We're going to see how to develop any desktop application and how to develop a web pages, how to connect to the website. That we're going to learn in this course. That is full stack, means that only, that is back end plus front end. So we are, in my syllabus, I'm focusing on J2SE and J2EE because that is the current demand in the company. J2ME is also there, but that is with respect to Android now. Now, those who want to work in Android application, then J2ME, they will go for. So Java, it's an object-oriented language. Object-oriented language, I will going to cover when we're going to see OOP concept. As of now, you just think like it's a methodology, like where we create a program in term of an object. What do you mean by this objects and all? We're going to see object is, okay. Yeah. Do you know?
Told us that in this we will create desktop application and web applications, right? So we can create a mobile applications. So this web application which we will develop using this J2EE, we can access it by using mobile devices, right? They can access it, but we can develop it using J2EE, right, sir?
No, you are taking it a wrong way. A mobile device means what?
Mobile device, I mean, you told us that we can't develop mobile devices. We are not discussing about developing mobile devices.
Yes.
We're discussing only about web applications and desktop applications.
Yeah.
So my doubt is that after we developing these web applications, it can be accessed by any Android users, right? Because it is
web application, you can access it, but I'm talking about application that you usually download from the Play Store. Like, right, you download from Play Store Android application, you run it, you install it. That will not going to see this because now we are not using any Java operating system anymore nowadays. This J2ME is now completely replaced by Android course.
Now we got it, sir.
Where you're going to learn how to develop Android application. How to develop Android operating system.
Yes, sir.
Android apps.
Yeah. Now I got it.
Okay. Now in the Java, it's an object-oriented programming, and Java files is like that you need to write one you can write once the code and you can run it on any operating system that I have already discussed with you, that it is a platform independent and portability. So this write once, run anywhere is the same thing. Suppose I will going to, every day I will going to create a programs in my Windows 10. And suppose if you are, and I will going to share you, okay? If you can see here, let me show you. Every day I used to upload programs on my GitHub account. Do you know about what is GitHub?
Yeah, so they will share the code developed.
Yes.
Many developers.
Yes. So every day I create programs and I just share here, right? So these are the Java programs. Now, when I will going to share and I will going to share the link with you, you will going to download it, right? I develop this programs in which operating system? Windows 10. Suppose if you are using Windows 7, Windows 8, 8.1, then will this program run? It should run as per the portability concept, right? That only says write once. I write the code once, but it can be run by multiple students in the class based on their operating system. Okay. So that is called as run. Write once, run anywhere. So once I write the code, we can run anywhere. I can design the web, internet applications, right? So this is an example of that. Now, just read this carefully. What actually is the difference between C and Java? Just read this and let me know like what you remember about C language. You studied C language, right? Both of you?
Yes, sir.
So just read these lines and let me know if anything that you remember from the C language.
Yes, sir.
Oh, now I can hear you, Supriya. Great. Yeah, just go through this and just let me know like, or just go through this point and just think like if you remember anything. So here, in this C language, there are a few things that we were missing in Java. The Java main focus was to reduce the complexity of the programs. Okay. Java main focus was to reduce the complexity of the program. And that's the reason many of the things that present in C++ was removed from Java. So just read this one and ask me if anything is not clear to you.
I got it, sir.
Okay. Afzal, you, Kumud,
yes,
Kumuda, any doubt in this point?
No, sir, we have understood.
Yes.
So what do you mean by this preprocessor? Are you aware
preprocessor? I understood, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Any question? Do you know everything like structure, sir, union? Yes.
Preprocessor means it's like an header files, right, sir? Just you know, sir, that preprocessor means we are defining like headers.
Yes, correct, correct. Your voice is breaking.
I should load.
Yes. Preprocessor means that we usually add in a C language. Hash define, hash include, stdio.h, hash include. Yes. So those are called preprocessor. Hash include conio.h.
Yeah. So those contain like,
yes.
For example, if hash include math.h means it will contains many equations and formulas for the mathematics problem in the code.
Yes.
So it contains libraries, right, sir?
Yeah. Those header file actually define the statement, the instruction, function, like printf. In C language, you use printf, right? If you use printf without studio.h, it will give you error. Why? Because the definition of that printf is defined in studio.h header file. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, if you want to use mathematical operation, like what is the mathematical operation you have used in C language? Do you remember?
Addition, subtraction.
Math.h.
Yes, correct. So in math.h, the functions are square root, power addition, right, and all that you are saying, that is not user-defined functions are available. Predefined function. But for calculating power, square root, mod, predefined functions are available.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so those are defined in math.h. Let me write it down. 1 minute. So here, this SQRT is for square root. This is for power, to find out the power. So they are defined in math.h. So this function, if you use in your program, how the compiler will know that this function is used to find out square root, this function is used to find out power. So their definition is defined in math.h. Similarly, printf, scanf that we use in C language, they define in studio.h. Get ch function that we use it to hold the output screen is defining conio.h. What about C++? Have you studied C++?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me in which library do we define C out and C in?
Yes, sir.
I use stream.h.
Correct.
I use stream.h.
Yes. So these are the like header files are there. So this preprocessor is based on that. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So in Java, we don't have a preprocessor. We don't have a pointer. We don't have a structure union that we have in a C language. We don't have a key, go to size of type def. Go to, have you used in Java, C language, go to jump?
Yes.
So those are not there in Java. Java main focus was to reduce the complexity of the program. That's why it has removed most of the concept from the Java language. And Java has a break and continue, and Java is a simple programming language, easy to learn it, because it has reduced most of the complexity that are present in C, C++. So this is about the difference between C language. If anyone asks you why I'm discussing all this thing, because in the first class itself, you should be clear about the motive, why we are learning this, what make us learn, because in interview, they might ask you the question. So you should be able to answer. You should know what is the difference between. Otherwise, you will you just start learning Java, but you don't know what is the missing in previous language that make you learn Java. So this answer normally everyone they ask in the interview. Suppose when they see your resume, they might ask you the first question of why you started learning Java or why you left C++. So you should be able to tell this point. So be remember this point. I will going to share with you. This slide will be shared with you in this repository. I will going to create a new repo for you. And with that, the recording also I will going to share with you so that you will going to you will be clear about it. Okay. So C++ also the same thing. We don't have a pointer. We don't have a memory location. Okay. And structure union if we don't have operator overloading. This all the thing we're going to see practically, because right now you won't understand this theory part, but I will going to explain you these differences. So what makes Java more popular is first is your OOP concept, inheritance, OOP concept. You might have studied in C++. Do you remember OOP concept?
Yes, sir.
What are the OOP concept? Can you name them?
It contains objects and classes, sir.
Yes.
Object.
What about other? Inheritance is there. Okay. Encapsulation. Polymorphism. Abstraction. Right. Yes, so sir. These are the OOPs concept are there that we're going to cover. We're going to see everything. Okay.